We were here this morning with Deep Blue Swimming at Bath. We're interviewing Mark Skimming, who's the head coach of the Bath Uni Swim. Did you have, in terms of when you were coaching, did you have any coaches that acted as a mentor for you? And if so, in what ways did they help you develop?
I had a few coaches who I regarded mentors. First one was Nick Selwood, who was my coach in Coventry. And got me coaching and started helping me with that side. He helped me a lot technically, and helped me a lot in knowing that the stats can be quite important. When I came to Bath, one of the biggest mentors I've had, and I still use, is Andrei Bronsov, who's head coach of Russia. Bring him up and often ask what he thinks of something and how he'd do it. The other guys that I get on with and talk to is a guy called Dave Keith fucking Ewing. Very much phone conversation every now and then. And mainly, how do I run the program with him? He's very good at running the program. And how do I sell it better? So, Nick, Andre, technical side, the work side. Since the ITC have been down, I've worked quite a bit from Ben McNulty, and we've got on really well. So there's been quite a lot of mentors. I get on with everyone. Dave Hall is another big one. I spend quite a lot of time with them at meets or when we're on campus together, and just listen to his stories and see what goes on.
When you're in coaching, what are your main philosophies? Like, do you like a big background of work, or do you focus more on skills, or is it kind of a mixed bunch?
It's a mixed bunch. I do like a big background of work. In all the swimmers that I've had, the ones that are able to deal with the work and cope with the work and put that consistently in are the ones that perform. We don't need to be excessive. We don't need to do 100k a week. But a big background or a decent background of work where they're fit and in shape. But coupled with that, I like to do a lot of skill work. More with the seniors, they take a little bit more own responsibility of choosing drills. But put in a lot of highly skilled work, just either distance off the wall, speed off the wall, distance per stroke. And then couple that together, and then put a little bit of speed in, and it varies up so that it gives a nice balance to the weeks, to the months. Swimmers don't get bored, and I don't get bored.
Can you? I know this one's a bit difficult at times, but can you give us three of your favourite sets working any energy system you like? The swimmers don't have to like the set.
My favourite sets. One of my favourite sets, which I haven't used for a while, I actually stole from Mick Selwood, three lots of 1050s, hold them as fast as you can. You do 10, you either do 2 and steady, or you get an extra 2 minutes, and they're off 70, and it's on number 1, and it's probably your fastest average. Probably what people class as a VO2 set, or a heart rate set. Only 1500, but it's pretty intense. Second set I like. I like to do a block of 100s. I play around with a number between 20 and 30. In blocks of 4 and 5, and we descend up and down, and then we hold, and then we go odds, hard, even steady. So it's not a specific set, but that I like to be able to do 3100s, lots of 5, descend and hold, descend, one on, one off, in that way. And then my last, I suppose my other favourite set, comes a little bit more from my start of the year. I like to go 10 to 100s, odds I am, evens, freestyle. For some of you really don't like that.
Do you pay any special attention to kick? And if so, as a typical amount, what would you like to get done most sessions, or a percentage of the session done?
We do kick every session. I pay a decent amount of attention to it. I do think it's important because they've got to be able to finish off their race. I think that's the first thing that goes. I don't specify an amount per session. It depends. If we do a longer aerobic session, then you might do 1,000, 1,200 kick, which will be fast and slow, and again playing with pace. If we're doing a hard set, so we do a heart rate set or a quality set, always back it up with probably a short kick set after, no more than 600, but real fast kicking off the back of that. So the kick's pretty important to me.
What would be a typical hard kick set for you that you'd like to torture the swimmers with?
I try not to torture my swimmers, even though some of my swimmers think that I do. My favourite off the back of a hard set, so off the back of a quality set, which can be anything up to probably 2,500, would be more like 1,250s, one going 25 flat out, one going 50 flat out, and then one going 25 flat out, and we do that four times. My other kick set's pretty basic that I like doing, that's 10-100s fast and heavy.
Old school.
Very.
Obviously now the IPC's come into Bath University, has that helped improve your programme?
I think that there's some good things and some bad things. I think it's improved in the fact that there's other people here that I can bounce ideas off, I can work with, and we can almost do some things together, but then in another world it sort of picks up on both programs, either what we're missing or how we can do things a little bit better. So it has improved it. We've lost a little bit of space, but in terms of the university program, we've got some good quality swimmers in who are working in the ITC and are swimming for the university and the university group.
And obviously myself being a young coach, if you could give three pieces of advice, what would they be?
First piece of advice, work down at the bottom level, understand what it takes to get the swimmers from a low level up to national A, national B. Understand the skills and the work that's needed there. Second bit, keep looking at ways, keep talking to people to move yourself on, to move your swimmers on and the program on. And third thing is you've got to enjoy it, it takes a hell of a lot of time.
Okay, thanks very much from Deep Blue. I hope you have a successful Olympics this summer.